as everybody knows, I'm Ty Montgomery. Very, very excited to join the Saints. Speaking with my agent, this was just a perfect opportunity for someone in my position who I guess you could say has kind of struggled a little bit in trying to find my niche or my role in offenses, just, you know, being drafted as a receiver and then moving to running back, sort of being in different boxes and trying to figure out, you know, how to fit, you know, the best in an offense. And I think the Saints offense gives me that. Obviously, with guys like Alvin Kamara, they've shown what they can do with guys like him. Taysom Hill, they've shown what they can do with guys like him. Just other guys as well over the years. Coach Sean Payton and his offense has just sort of been, I guess you could say, notorious for putting guys in the best positions to be successful and being very creative on offense.
Yeah, like you alluded to, my name's Amy Just. So I cover the Saints for the Times-Picayune here. Sean Payton doesn't really believe in boxes on offense. He has a vision for people and lets them do it. So just knowing how your career has gone, how exciting is that for you that you may not necessarily have to fit in a box, and that's okay?
Yeah. I actually think that's something I spoke about when I first made the transition. I was in Green Bay. Everyone talked about, oh, you're a running back now. What does this mean for you as a receiver, your abilities as a receiver? And, you know, I've always said I don't believe I necessarily have to fit into a box. You know, I can sit in a running back room and still do things as a wide receiver. I can sit in a receiver room and still do things as a running back. My ultimate goal is just to be able to play and help the team in any way I can. And God has blessed me with some gifts and abilities, and I just want to be able to take advantage of those. So, you know, I'm very happy to be here.
Ty, has it been tough or frustrating, I guess, to move around positions, you know, get switched like that? Was that frustrating for you?
The initial switch wasn't frustrating. I guess, you know, at times what became frustrating is I would be limited to third and longs and, you know, obviously third and longs are majority just screens and not even really a lot of runs. You know, the runs and touches I would get would come at the end of games. Either we're getting blown out or we're blowing out the other team. And that's been a little frustrating because I've just been trying to find my role just to be able to help in any way I can.
Ty, how familiar are you with the Saints offense, and I guess specifically with the ball distribution, because a lot of guys get their hands on the ball in this offense?
Yeah, so being someone who's, you know, from the outside looking in, talking with ex-teammates and whatnot, you know, we just discussed how New Orleans would actually be a perfect fit for me. Just because there's times where I remember one year it was Mark and Alvin, you didn't know who, you couldn't really tell who was the starter. Both those guys had a lot of production, you know, easily, you know, over the 1,200 all-purpose yard mark. Taysom Hill, we were actually in Green Bay together, and so I already knew what kind of athlete he was. So to see him thrive, catch balls, run the football, throw the football, I was already pretty familiar with this offense and this offense putting guys in positions to win. Obviously, being with Jimmy in Green Bay, he talked about it a little bit. Watching what Jared Cook has been doing, we were in Green Bay together. You know, it's just a place where anybody can thrive, really.
How special is it for you to be back in the South, man?
You know what, man? I'm so excited about that, especially my family. All my roots are Mississippi, Tennessee, and Texas. I got some family in Alabama as well, so everybody's really excited. Everybody's talking about they can drive to games now. They can afford to come to the games. I have some family in Monroe, Louisiana as well, and Negatives. So I'm very excited to be back in the South, get away from that cold weather for a little bit.
I see you were born in Jackson. When did you leave Mississippi?
I was a young pup. I've been in Texas probably since my pre-K years. Been in Dallas since kindergarten, but I've always gone back to Mississippi. Biological father and his family's in Mississippi. My mom's side of the family, great kinfolk there from Starkville, Mississippi and Columbus. So I go back to Mississippi a little bit.
Yeah, like you said, you're reuniting with some Green Bay teammates. I think you have at least one college teammate too. But what's that like? You know, you're going to a new team, but there are going to be plenty of familiar faces.
Kind of makes me feel comfortable, really. See some guys I know, guys that can help me learn the New Orleans way of doing things. And, you know, I'm just going to come in every day, go to work, and just try to enjoy the guys around me. I will say it seems like it's a very fun atmosphere as well from the outside looking in. I've never heard any bad things about New Orleans. Everybody says they love it. Training camp's hard. Everybody works hard, but everybody has fun and has fun playing the game. So I'm excited for that.
Have you played in the dome?
You mentioned being teammates with Taysom Hill. Did you ever think during that summer that you'd be competing for snaps with him? You both kind of have similar undefined roles in this offense now.
So I'm going to answer Walker's question first. I've not played in the dome before. And as far as competing with Taysom Hill, I think that's one of the cool things about not fitting into a box. And you know, Taysom can play running back, quarterback, or receiver. I feel as though I can play running back or receiver or just help out in other ways. I've even played fullback a few times when I was in Green Bay lead blocking for the other halfbacks and Pony. So, you know, I don't really see it as competing against one another. I mean, you're competing against everybody every single day. Everybody's trying to fight and make the 53-man roster. But, you know, if there's a package for me that maybe I'm able to do better than Taysom in terms of running the ball, Taysom's got his packages that he's going to be able to do better than me in terms of running the ball or throwing the ball or catching the ball. So I think that's one of the benefits of not really being limited to just one box per se, is that if somebody else does something well, you can go do something else. You know, that's the value in being able to do more. You know, they always say the more you can do, the better.
Does anyone else have any questions for Ty?
Rod, you're muted.
Oh, I'm unmuted now. Ty, you said you never played in the dome. Have you been in New Orleans a lot, though? Is it a place you visited growing up in the South or no?
No, not really. I've been to New Orleans once for a fishing trip. I forget where we went. It was probably about a couple hours outside of New Orleans. I walked down Bourbon Street. I'm not a huge partier or drinker or anything like that. I'm more of like a find a spot with some good music, find a good restaurant, maybe have a glass of wine or something like that. But I love to eat. I can have a good time too. You know, I can enjoy Bourbon Street, but you know, I'm excited about the city. I'll tell you that much.